energy of net kinetic energy by kinetic energy of rotation is equal to k square plus r square by k square. Okay, so this is one. Otherwise, kinetic energy of rotation, kinetic energy of net. This is reverse this k square by k square plus r square. So this one formula, right? Again, kinetic energy of linear. Kinetic energy of linear by kinetic energy of net is equal to r square by k square plus r square. If k square plus r square is large, then motion is pure translatory. Pure translatory motion. If r square by k square plus r square is large, then motion is pure circular motion. Okay, so these points are very, very important. Here k means radius of gyration. So this k is equal to square root of i by m. I means here moment of inertia. I means what, my here? Moment of inertia. I is equal to moment of inertia. Okay, omega means angular velocity. So this is about kinetic energy net, kinetic energy rotation, and kinetic energy linear relations. Next, we are move on to the most important topic in this rolling and rotatory motion. So please watch the lecture carefully. Well, hi, hello, my dear students. Welcome to my video lecture class. Right up to now, I uploaded video lectures on the topic system of particles and rotation. So today I am going to discuss a newer concept and newer problem. So regarding this system of particles and rotation, so please watch the lecture till the end. Definitely you will get a clear idea about this chapter. So please watch carefully. Here this concept is very, very helpful to solve numericals, and this is a very important too. Okay, so in JEE and NEET, so many times as we observed previous years, so many times questions was asked based upon this concept. So please watch the lecture carefully. So now application of rolling motion. Okay, let us consider a body. Let us consider a body of mass m and radius r, moment of inertia, radius r, and moment of inertia I, which is rolling rolling down the inclined plane without slip. This is very important. Rolling down the inclined plane without slip. So that means some necessary frictional force. Keep without slipping. Add sir. So now we need to then find. Well, to continuing my lecture on the topic rotation. In this topic, I already explained rolling motion, forward slip, backward slip, and kinetic energy of rolling, kinetic energy of rotation, kinetic energy of translatory motion, relation between net kinetic energy, rotational kinetic energy, translational kinetic energy. So these are all things I discussed in previous lectures. Please watch that previous lectures for better understanding. Today I am going to discuss one more important topic regarding this rolling motion. So please watch the lecture till the end. Definitely you will get a clear idea about this chapter. Right, here applications of rolling motion. This application is very, very important. Very, very important. This application is very important. Observe carefully. Let us consider a body of mass M and radius R, moment of inertia I, which is rolling down the inclined plane. Without slip. This term is very important. Rolling down the inclined plane without slip. That means some necessary frictional force adds. Then find acceleration. Second one. Frictional force. Third one. Velocity. And fourth one. Time. Next. Fifth one. Coefficient of friction. Okay, so these all we need to find from this data. So observe carefully. Here I'll consider, I draw a diagram here. Observe carefully. So this is a diagram I'll draw here. So inclined plane having an angle theta. Here is the body. It is rolling, so it's rolling down the inclined plane. Okay, so here this acceleration is downward. Here acceleration is downward because we're rolling downwards down the inclined plane. So here normal force is acts upward direction. This is normal force, and weight mg is acts downward direction. So here observe carefully. In inclined plane, weight mg is acts like this. Okay. So if you consider weight m. This is theta, means here also angle theta. This is mg cos theta, and this is mg sin theta. This is mg sin theta. Mg sin theta. Here weight is mg, and frictional force is acts upward direction. Here is a frictional force. So like this all forces acting on this spherical body. All the forces are acting on this spherical body. Here theta is angle of inclination. Theta is angle of inclination. So here this body is rolling down the inclined plane without slip. Without slip. How to find acceleration here? So acceleration formula here. Acceleration. A is equal to g sine theta by 1 plus k square by r square. So this is acceleration formula. So we had some derivations, but no need of derivations. So just remember this formula. Acceleration A is equal to g sine theta by 1 plus k square by r square. And second formula, frictional force F is equal to mg sine theta by 1 plus r square by k square. So this is frictional force formula. Frictional force F is equal to mg sine theta by 1 plus r square by k square. So next term. Well, acceleration formula is g sine theta by 1 plus k square by r square. F is equal to mg sin theta by 1 plus r square by k square. Frictional force F is equal to. Next, velocity formula. Here velocity V formula. Body is rolls down the inclined plane without slip. What is the velocity here? Velocity V is equal to root 2gh. 2g means g sine theta. Okay. H means g sine theta. H means here L by 1 plus k square by r square. So here velocity V is equal to, this is a formula. So V is equal to square root of 2g L sine theta by 1 plus k square by r square. Okay, so this is velocity formula. This is third formula. Velocity. 2g L sine theta by 1 plus k square plus r square. So here fourth one. T is equal to 2h by g. That means 2 L by g means g sine theta into 1 plus k square by r square. So this is a time. Time taken by body to reach bottom. Time taken by body to reach bottom is square root of 2L by g sine theta into 1 plus k square by r square. Next. Fifth formula. So coefficient of friction. Friction mu is equal to tan theta by 1 plus r square by k square. Here we consider radius is capital R. Because we are taking in all formulas capital R. So radius is capital R. Okay. Here R means radius. Theta means angle of inclination. Radius of body. Okay. Angle of inclination. Okay. K means radius of gyration. Okay, so r theta k here. So this is about acceleration, friction and velocity, time, coefficient of friction formulas. Whether one body is rolls down the inclined plane without slip. Okay, so this is about body rolls down without slip. Next, for this Now I consider body rolls down the inclined plane without slip. We got all formulas. Body rolls down the inclined plane without slip. Body rolls down the inclined plane without slip. Okay, so here is a body. I'll consider bodies are one solid sphere, two solid cylinder, or circular disc. Next, the third one, hollow sphere, fourth one, hollow cylinder or circular ring. Okay, let us consider bodies are. I'll consider these four bodies. One is a solid sphere, another one is solid cylinder or circular disc, third one is hollow sphere, hollow cylinder or circular ring. So I'll consider these four. So these four is rolls down the inclined plane. These are all rolls down the inclined plane, which one is reach bottom plane without slip? This is very important. Without slip, which one is reach bottom first? So here answer for this one is solid sphere reach bottom of inclined plane first. At last, hollow cylinder or circular ring reaches the bottom of inclined plane. Okay. So these four bodies are rolls down the inclined plane. Which is reach first? Solid sphere is reach the bottom first. Next, which is reaches last? Hollow cylinder or circular ring reaches bottom of inclined plane last. At last, so hollow sphere is reaches the bottom of the inclined plane last. Hollow cylinder reaches first. Solid sphere is reaches. So now you have a doubt. Why solid sphere reaches first and why hollow cylinder reaches next? Because due to these relations, due to these relations. These relations are very important. Now I discussed those relations. Based upon these relations only, we concluded that solid sphere is reaches first. What is that relation? Solid sphere, acceleration of solid sphere is greater than acceleration of solid cylinder is greater than acceleration of hollow cylinder, say sphere is greater than acceleration of first relation. Okay, acceleration of hollow cylinder. Okay, relation of acceleration. Next, similarly, acceleration like this we are taking. Time taken, time of solid sphere is less than time of solid cylinder is less than time of hollow sphere is less than time of hollow cylinder. So time of hollow cylinder will take more time. Which one having more acceleration? Solid sphere has more acceleration. Solid cylinder taking less time. Less time. Similarly, if acceleration is more means it reaches first. It reaches first means time is less. Okay, next. Coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction of solid sphere is less than. Coefficient of friction of solid cylinder is less than. Coefficient of friction of horizontal cylinder is less than. Coefficient of friction of horizontal cylinder. Okay. These are all data is very important for us. Next, velocity. Fourth one. Velocity of solid sphere is greater than velocity of solid cylinder is greater than velocity of horizontal cylinder sphere and the velocity of horizontal cylinder. So here SS means solid sphere, SC means solid cylinder, HS means hollow sphere, HC means hollow cylinder. I'll consider here SS. So here hollow sphere means HS, hollow cylinder means HC. Hollow sphere means hollow sphere HS. Now solid cylinder. Solid cylinder is SC. Solid cylinder SC. Solid sphere. Yes. Okay. So these are the acceleration. So when these are applied, if a body rolls down the inclined plane. Without slip. So these relations are very, very important. So while solving numericals, how the questions are asked in NEET and JEE. So let us consider inclined plane. Four bodies I consider: solid sphere, solid cylinder, hollow sphere, hollow cylinder. These are all are rolls down the inclined plane. Which one is reached first? Which one is reached first? Solid sphere is reached first because acceleration of solid sphere is greater than that of solid cylinder, because for the solid cylinder friction is less, coefficient of friction is less. Next, we are move on to the topic. For the solid sphere, is taken as one. So this is a solid sphere. Some matter is inside it. So matter is inside it means that is solid sphere. Some matter inside it. Some matter is inside it. Okay, so matter is inside it, this is a solid sphere. So for this solid sphere, coefficient of friction I is equal to 2/5 mr². Coefficient of friction I is equal to 2/5 mr². Next, coefficient of friction 2/5 mr², then I is equal to 2 by 5 m r square means I is equal to, we know that m k square. So from this 2 we concluded that k square is equal to 2 by 5 r square. So from this k square by r square value is 2 by 5. Okay, k square is equal to, so from this 2, so equate k square is equal to what we got now, 2 by 5 r square, k square by r square value is 2 by 5. So from this acceleration a is equal to formula g sin theta by 1 plus k square by r square. So from this g sin theta by, so body rolls down the inclined plane, acceleration of solid sphere is g sin theta by 1 plus k square by r square value is 2 by 5. So from this 2 by 5, 5 plus 2 7, 7 by 5, that means 5g sin theta by 7. So that is acceleration of solid sphere. What is acceleration of solid sphere? 5g sin theta by 7. This is the first parameter we got done. First parameter. Similarly, we are finding, if you know k square r square formula, k square by r square formula, then it is easy to find velocity. Velocity formula, v is equal to square root of 2 g sin theta into l by, so g sin theta l by, so 2 g sin theta l by 1 plus k square by r square. So from this 2 g sin theta into l by 1 plus k square by r square means 2 by 5. So from this we got 2 g sin theta into l by, so that is 7 by 5. So that means 5 2 is 10. 10 g sin theta into l by, okay, so here 7. So this is a velocity of solid sphere, velocity of solid sphere, whether it is rolls down the inclined plane without slip. So if you know the k square by r square value, it is easy to find acceleration, velocity, coefficient of friction. So these are all values easy to find. So second we got. Next term, time. So time is equal to, here third one, time is equal to, so how to find time? Time is equal to 2h by g, that means 2l by g sin theta into 1 plus k square by r square. So from this we got 2l by g sin theta 1 plus k square by r square. K square by r square value is 2 by 5. So from this 5 plus 2 7, 7 by 5, 7 2 is 14. Is it or not? So 14L by 5G sin theta. This is a time taken by solid sphere to reach bottom. Time taken by solid sphere to reach bottom of inclined plane. Bottom of inclined plane. Time taken by solid sphere to reach bottom of inclined plane. So we got square root of 14L by g sin theta. So this is about time. Next formula is coefficient of friction. So acceleration, you know, coefficient of friction. Fourth one. Mu is equal to tan theta by 1 plus r square by k square. So tan theta by 1 plus r square by k square means 5 by 2. K square by r square means 2 by 5. So 5 by 2 we are taking. So from this 2 tan theta by 7. So 2 tan theta by 7. This is the coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction of solid sphere. Okay. Coefficient of friction of solid sphere. So next parameter is frictional force. Frictional force. Mg sin theta by 1 plus r square by a square. Observe here carefully. Mg sin theta by 1 plus r square by k square means 5 by 2. So from this, 2 mg sin theta by 5. So this is frictional force. So this is frictional force we got. Similarly, for the solid cylinder, hollow sphere, and so if you know this all the things, k square by r square value, k square by r square value, you know, if we know k square by r square value, then easy to find acceleration, velocity, next third one height, next fourth one coefficient of friction, fifth one frictional force. So easy to find these all parameters. Okay, so for any body, if you know the k square by r square value, then easy to find for any body A, B, T, mu, F. Okay, so now I'll consider solid sphere. Next, solid cylinder. Well, solid cylinder. Second one is solid cylinder. For solid cylinder, I consider. So this is a cylinder. We consider like this. Otherwise, here like this also. Solid cylinder. So this is total or matter. This is total is matter. Okay. So this total is matter here. This is total matter. Solid cylinder. If you consider this is a total filled with matter, and this is I is equal to mr square by 2. So similarly for hollow mr square by 2, circular disc also, moment of inertia, circular disc. So this is circular disc I consider. So for this also, I is equal to mr square by 2, I consider. For circular disc, mr square by 2. And for solid cylinder also, mr square by 2. So from this, I is equal to mk square. So from this, k square is equal to r square by 2. So from this, k square by r square is equal to 1 by 2. So k square by r square is equal to. So now, if you know k square by r square, then it is easy to find. So it is easy to find a value. So I left for you. So students, please remember, if you know the k square by r square value, it is easy to find a value and V value, T value, F value, and mu value. I already find for circular solid sphere. So now you need to find here A value. So if you know the A value and V value is easy to find because you know already formula. So we substitute K square by R square value in this formula. So you got all values. F value and fourth one, mu value. Okay. a, b, f, t and the t value also. So we got all these values. Okay, next. Solid cylinder like this. Next, hollow sphere. Hollow sphere. Hollow sphere. Hollow is hollow sphere. If you consider hollow sphere. Third one is hollow sphere. So for a hollow sphere, this is a hollow sphere I consider. For a hollow sphere, moment of inertia I is equal to 2 by 3 m r square. So that means I is equal to m k square. Then k square is equal to from these two, k square is equal to, so from these two, k square is equal to what we got? 2 by 3 r square. So k square by r square is equal to what we got? 2 by 3. So if you know the 2 by 3 value, it is easy to find. A value is easy to find. So find A and F value, V value, next fourth one T value and coefficient of friction U value. So if you know the k square by r square value, it is easy to find a value, f value and v value, t value and u value for hollow sphere. So next, this is hollow sphere. Next is hollow cylinder or circular ring. Hollow cylinder. Hollow cylinder or circular ring. Circular ring. So if you consider hollow cylinder or circular ring, this is a hollow cylinder. For this hollow cylinder, coefficient of friction I is equal to m r square. So I is equal to m k square, already you know. So k square is equal to, we got r square. So from this k square by r square is equal to 1. So for circular ring also, this is hollow cylinder. This is for hollow cylinder. Circular ring also same. For circular ring, circular ring. This is circular ring. So if you know the circular ring, moment of inertia is mr square. So that means I is equal to mk square. Then k square by r square is equal to here also 1. So if you know the k square by r square value, if we know k square by r square values, it's easy to find 1 acceleration, 2 velocity, 3 time, 4 frictional force, 5 coefficient of friction. It's easy to find coefficient of friction. So for observe carefully, find a value, mu value, t value, v value and f value. For solid sphere, solid cylinder, hollow sphere and a hollow cylinder and frame a table, we got so these all relations in a particular table. Okay, so I'll give notes for this rotation and the system of particles. I hope you are all understood this lecture. So please solve this A, V, T, F and U. I already solved for solid sphere. Similarly, you have to solve. So all remaining solid cylinder, hollow cylinder and hollow sphere, you have to solve and frame a table, those readings. Those readings are very helpful to solve numericals. I hope you are all understood this lecture. If you will get any doubt regarding this lecture, feel free to mention in comment box. Thank you for watching my lectures. Thank you for encouraging me. Thank you so much.